Little Estella at that time?
Little Estella, yes. As a poor Estella, it's hard for her to grow out of being Little Estella, even though she's now 80-something. So Little Estella fell naturally into the natural history and became a palynologist. Very good palynologist.
Estella Leopold is a University of Washington Professor Emerita of Botany, Forest Resources, and Quaternary Studies, and has been teaching and conducting research for more than 60 years. The author of over 100 scientific publications, Estella pioneered the use of fossilized pollen and spores to understand how plants and ecosystems respond over eons to climate change and other environmental factors. Along with her brothers, Starker and Luna, she was elected to the National Academy of Sciences, making the Leopolds the only family in the 150-year history of the Academy to have three siblings so honored.
Well, we were alone at the shack one time, and I said to Dad, I think I'd like to become an entomologist. And Dad looked at me and said, oh, okay. And talk about it. So we talked about it. I said, everything is taken, Dad. What else is there? Anyway, a little while later in the conversation, he said, now, remind me when we get back from the shack to go down to Brown's Bookstore, and I'm going to buy you a copy of Facets of Spring Flora and a hand lens and a vasculum, and let's see what you can do with that. And the next weekend at the shack, and it was spring. And he handed me this gear, and I took a walk over behind the sandhill, dropped down into the wetland, and I found a beautiful yellow plant with a little brown center. It was about this high, and I sat there and tediously keyed this thing out. I'll never forget it. It was Lysimacea quadrifolia.
No kidding.
And it was my first plant. I was so happy.
Oh, great. That was neat.
Collected it in the vasculum back and showed it to Dad. He said, very good. Did you enjoy that? And I said, yeah, that was great. And I went into botany. I always knew that I was going to take Dad's course, which was Wildlife Ecology 118. Well, one of the things about this class that was alarming to me was to go to class and raise my hand when Dad would ask a question. And he would call on me as, baby, would you like to answer that question? And I was just paralyzed with it. It wasn't until the Wilderness Act came up that I really got into conservation myself. The friends that I made in Denver knew of Dad's name, and they said, hey, Estella, you got to come in and help us testify on this act. We had been aware that the Florissant fossil beds were in danger of being developed by a private developer, and we had a short window on this. We said we only have a couple of months to fight this and get a bill into the Congress and get something going on it. Vic Anacone, the lawyer, told us, well, what you need to do down here is write up a brief for a law case. The testimony we were going to give, he rejected each time, saying, now, why are you really trying to save these beds? And I rewrote that testimony two or three times. And the night before we got up in front of the Senate committee, I stayed up all night long redrafting this testimony to talk about ethics and aesthetics of covering these fossils, which had so much intrinsic value for the general public. Well, it was pretty good testimony, but it had to be through the urging of Vic Anacone, saying, you've got to really understand why, in the long term, the public values are at stake here. Don't just talk about science, he said. Talk about your values.